Today, the self-appointed commissioner of tennis has decided to be serious because of all the commotion caused by an American player he had never even seen before. Tennis Sandgren, your amazing run at the Australian Open has sadly been overshadowed by all the revelations of your online social activity. Look, I'm not here to judge you. I don't even know you, where you came from, and what kind of education you've received. But I heard you say, I want to learn. I'm only 26. Well, the self-appointed commissioner of tennis would like to teach you about some important events in the history of our sport. In 1937, the great German player Gottfried von Kramm got a call from Adolf Hitler just before a match at Wimbledon to wish him luck. Just a few months later, he was jailed and persecuted by the Nazis for being homosexual. I know, you must be thinking, why is this old fart trying to give me a history lesson? Well, tennis, there's a lot we can learn from the past. In 1969, Arthur Ashe was denied a visa to go and play in South Africa because he was black. He would then lead a fight against apartheid in South Africa that would eventually result in that country being banned from the Davis Cup. Meanwhile, Billie Jean King was fighting her own battle for gender equality in sport and in society. You see, tennis, in those days, they couldn't tweet their opinions. You actually had to do something in order to be heard. And what about the Indo-Pak Express, the doubles pair created by the Pakistani Qureshi and the Indian Bhupana, to try to bring peace between their two countries? Have you heard of Althea Gibson, Martina Navratilova, Venus and Serena Williams, among others? All of these relentless fighters and pioneers for these noble causes. Have you heard about equal prize money and how tennis was the first sport to make it a reality? These heroes reshaped our sport and left us a common heritage we have to treasure. Yeah, we get to shine on the court, but it gives us a responsibility. As world travelers, we have to carry a message. Let's embrace our differences. I promise you, it'll make you 10 times richer than any Grand Slam victory could. It's up to you, tennis.
John?
Yeah.
Can we embrace our differences right now?
Yeah, let's do it.
Because I've got a bit of a money problem, mate.